Well, the First World War was really the roots of the United States' position in a modern globalized world. So if we really want to understand how we got to where we are today, that's a good place to start. And just in terms of commemorating and looking at history, there's a famous quote that people say, history repeats itself. Well, it really doesn't. Mark Twain had a much better version of it. He said, history doesn't repeat itself, but it rhymes. And I think if we look back at these kinds of events where people might have difficulty saying, well, how does that relate to my world today? It may not relate exactly as you see it historically, but the themes and the concepts and ideas for how we may get along in our current world are certainly there. So the First World War certainly rhymes with our own time. Well, I think if we really want to understand why the First World War matters today, in terms of the United States perspective in particular, today we're at the center of the world stage, we're an important global leader. Before the First World War, the United States did not play that role. We really were a very inward-looking nation, and now we're a very outward-looking nation in a lot of ways. And the role of the United States in the end of the First World War and its role in the peace process afterwards really was the beginnings of that. So in many ways, for the United States, in terms of being a world leader, it's the First World War, not as much the Second World War, that really matters. Why is it important to study history? Well, first of all, it's fun. We can always see lots of interesting stories and great characters. True stories can be as exciting and in many ways even more exciting than fictional stories. But it also, again, gives us a perspective on our own time. It really allows us to really understand where we are and where we're going. And without that, we can't go forward. Well, the First World War really changed the world in so many ways. There's the obvious geopolitical situation and just changing the map, literally, and having different powers rise to the leadership roles, the United States in particular. But in so many ways, technologically, the world changed. Advances in medicine, advances in industrial production. Of course, in my particular specialty, the history of aviation, aircraft went from flying 50 miles an hour and barely able to fly to going three times that fast and having large bombers and fighters. So the development of the technology was incredibly rapid. Our understanding of world war in the sense that putting civilians in the conflict. We no longer had just soldiers going to a battlefield and that was war. Now war involved all aspects of society. Urban centers, industrial production, personal participation in a vast scale given the millions of people who participated. So it really just changed the way we see our modern world. My interest in history is from the earliest days. Even when I was a little boy, I was always dragging my parents to museums rather than the other way around. I'm not quite sure where that emerged, but I certainly have an interesting personal history. My parents came from Hungary. They emigrated from Hungary during the 1956 revolution. So I had a father who fought in the Hungarian army in the Second World War and a grandfather who fought in the Austro-Hungarian army in the First World War. And many military people in my family on the European side. So when I look at my family background, there's a lot of great stories. So I guess that's probably is what sparked my interest.